What is this? What is
this?
Does anybody know CPR?
Stuart, if I knew CPR, I would have been pounding on your chest at the gym.
Okay, Sarah, you said if we sweat, we got ice cream. See that? Sweat.
All right, help yourself.
Where's Emily?
Oh, she's at the library studying. Seems like that's all she ever does.
I wish I had students like that. My kids think the library is a place where you meet to buy term papers.
You know, Emily is number one in her class.
There's no boys in this school. She has nothing else to think about.
Yeah, an all-girls school certainly would have helped my grades.
Emily doesn't know the first thing about boys. You know, she asked me if you're allowed to kiss with your eyes open.
Are you?
When my mother explained the facts of life to me, neither of us had any idea what she was talking about.
Well, at least you talked to her. I was afraid my mother would be ashamed of me for wanting to know about sex. So I wrote her an anonymous note. She still thinks it's from my dad.
You know what happened to me?
What?
What?
My parents decided to tell me the truth about Santa Claus, the Easter Bunny, and the birds and the bees all on the same day. I bought 2 out of 3.
I just found out I have to teach some sex education next semester. The thing that worries me is, what do you give them for homework?
Oh, it's amazing to me how fast kids grow. With a little makeup and the right outfit, Emily is a knockout.
Mm-hmm. Well, who isn't?
You guys, I got a message. It's my very first message on my new machine.
Oh, boy, I'm going to save it.
Did you think you should listen to it first?
No. Right, rewind. Okay. Do you mind?
McKenna Cooper here. Is this thing on? Testing 1, 2, 3. What the heck? I'm gonna talk whether it's on or not. McKenna, I want you to work on Saturday.
Sir Glad, I don't have an answer machine.
If you see Kemper, tell him to be there too.
Because I have a very important message to leave you. Remember last night when you told me that I don't have enough fun?
Yes?
I took your advice and got all dressed up and went to Shannon's, that lawyer thing after you told me about. Anyway, remember that you said that the right time to stop being a virgin was when you met the right guy?
No.
I think I met him.
Hey, come on, kid, the meter's running.
Okay, do you think it's possible for someone to sound exactly like Marty? A lovely young man, a seminary student, perhaps?
It's possible.
Okay, would a seminary student call someone kitten?
Under certain circumstances.
Name one.
Anybody?
Maybe she reminded him of the sweet little kitty he had when he was growing up.
Exactly. All right, then answer me this. What is a seminary student doing at Shannon's?
Steward.
Maybe his church mobile broke down on the way to the seminary, and he went in to use the phone. And while he was there, he decided to mingle.
Oh, my God. Marty is with Emily.
Oh.
I have to stop her before she makes the biggest mistake of her life.
Here, why don't we run down to Shannon's? Maybe we can catch him.
Oh, would you? Great idea. And I'll go to Marty's apartment. Oh, I never thought I'd hear myself say those words.
Good morning, Helen.
Good morning, Mr. Cooper.
Boy, it feels good to be practicing law again. I feel like a new man.
Well, that's interesting, because since you came here, I feel like a new woman.
Really? I'm glad. Kemper! How did it go in court today?
What does this tell you?
You won the case?
No, but... it's hard to yell at someone who's smiling, isn't it?
Well, I don't want to yell at you. I just want the two of us to go over every detail of the case so we can learn from your mistakes. And when we finish doing that, then I'll yell at you.
He likes me.